We've just come to the end of a fantastic two-day conference, Universal Design and Learning. How do we transform higher education in Ireland? And that really is, how do we put the learner at the centre of all we do?
Delighted to see such a great crowd here today. There are no strangers here, only friends who've not yet met. So hopefully over the next 2 days you will make lots of new friends.
They brought with them a range of expertise, a range of knowledge and real life experience in addressing the diversity that we all meet in everyday life. And that's what made this conference so unique.
And we all have different abilities. You might be left-handed, like me, for example. English might not be your first language. And I'm sure we have all experienced some degree of difficulty at some stage in our lives where a better design could have made things easier.
But I particularly welcome those who have come from outside of Ireland here to the conference. Indeed, I think this is a real opportunity to share experience and to share best practice. It will inform both practice across the educational sector and indeed in the wider public service, but also policy. And as Minister, I think it's important that I should also learn from your deliberations.
And I will be your MC over the next day and a half. So if there's anything you need, please come to me or one of our student helpers. We have over 250 educators attending this conference, the largest national conference we've ever held on universal design.
Universal design is about coming to the core of looking at what are the needs of people, and every person has different needs, so let's have a look at all those needs and try and make the best product or the best design or the best environment we can.
Anybody is here who's an interest in education, and so it's possible for people to connect together and have conversations and have ideas become formed.
Have workshops, mostly skill-based workshops today, so there'll be a lot of interaction. If at any point you're having a difficulty or being asked to do something that you're not comfortable with doing or unable to do, please put up your hand, ask for assistance. Okay, we have some really interesting keynote speeches as well today.
We had David Rose, who presented us with his fantastic workman background from the CAST Centre based out of the School of Education in Harvard.
Universal Design for Learning is not about kids at the bottom of any distribution, but how do we create media that are strong enough to handle the full diversity of students we're likely to face? So if students are bored, then you're not doing a good enough universal design for learning. It's not about just raising the floor, it's about raising the ceiling as well.
David Rose was a bit of a rock star. The way he particularly tied kind of emotion into education and universal design.
I've just really enjoyed the speakers and just their enthusiasm, and there's a lovely network of people here that are really enthusiastic about it.
You turn a hunch into an idea, idea becomes a concept, concept becomes a product or something entirely useful. That's basically the business we're in.
We're all so different. It's not about person A or B or C. It's about the diversity of people, and we are all changing. We change, our conditions in life change. You selected the place here, you're moving your chair to feel comfortable, turning around. It's a design act, it's an act of design, but you are not thinking self-consciously about what you're doing, but constantly we are designing, we are redesigning.
They were advocating universal design principles being applied in healthcare, and we're saying, well, it's happening in every area of life, in retail, in leisure, in transport and tourism, to improve the citizen, the user experience.
This is the year of design here in Ireland, and universal design really is an aspect that's sometimes overlooked and needs to be much more widely engaged with. And I think the conference is really focusing people's attention on universal design and the benefits that come from that.
The fact that we have a wide variety of people sitting here, it's not necessarily just for one element of audience. It's for those who are interested in education and education being at its best for the most diverse population out there.
We had various opportunities to move into different workshop sessions, again with keynote presentations, and some of these were skills-based. Others then dealt with specific industries. So really, it was an agenda to address that diversity.
So we made great connections, and I think the power of the connection with Universal Design is very, very important. And our key message is that good design enables.
MOOC platforms for teaching Universal Design.
So we have these discussions. The reason why we have a discussion like that is it goes back to engagement. What you're trying to do is provoke a reaction. You're trying to get engagement, you're trying to make these issues personal. So that's something that we're trying to achieve.
It's vital to have these kind of events, particularly around the area of universal design and assistive technology. It's really changing on an almost monthly basis, so you need to meet people, hear what's new, hear what's interesting. It's a very dynamic area and you can't really sit still.
We want them going into university as creative problem solvers. We want them to develop critical thinking. We want them to work in teams. So universal design actually gives teachers and young people a structure that in which they can do that.
Well, there's a common interest, I would say, even though people are not necessarily from the same background. Everybody is talking about basically one big topic.
Conferences like this are really useful because you bring like-minded people together, and it's the conversations that happen around coffee time or after the main events are very important.
Another key element of this conference was to ensure that the student voice and the end user voice was incorporated. And James Hubbard and Oni from the Norwegian Centre for Design were instrumental in pulling together a 24-hour hackathon. Design or sometimes redesign a new product.
We have 24 hours. We'll be back in this auditorium with the 50 people that are at the back of the room. And it's my job to start the countdown. So I'm setting the clock and it starts from now.
The hackathon is the whole idea of redesigning something that already exists. So we were basically all brought into this conference room here and just kind of not even told our brief, not even told what was going on, just kind of told these are the people you're going to be working with for the next 24 hours. You're all from different backgrounds. And then we had also our lead users join us, who we were kind of designing the product for, whatever we were making. It was kind of who we were designing it for.
And our starting point was to see what already existed in the market. There's a visual on the stage, but it is a rickety old key that is possibly the length of most of my femur bones. We wanted to hack this design, to create something new.
What they produced really allowed us to see that this isn't purely theory, this works. This was real. Practical example. If we can come up with redesigns for products, we can redesign services. If we can redesign services, we can redesign programs. And before you know it, we can redesign higher education.
Myself and the other judges really warmed to see the quality of presentations and the thought that's gone into the last 24 hours. I'd like to say that the winner is Team D Access.
We have the technology, we have the design, we have the innovation, we've got the wonderful imaginations in Ireland, and you know, why not use this and bring it into every aspect and let's change the world one minute at a time.
It's been a fantastic 2 days. We're bowled over by the expertise and all the learning. Together we had an opportunity to explore, to learn, to discuss, and to consider what makes it possible to successfully adopt universal design in education.
If we could have locked the doors and kept everybody in here, we could have redesigned higher education secondary education and primary education, and we could have ensured that all the learners would have that optimal experience that they deserve.